Dear student, due to coronavirus, school started online classes for your study. So you can subscribe Golden Flower Palia YouTube channel, like and press the bell icon.
Hello students, as on first video classes, I have to explain the meaning and definitions of the management and process effectiveness and efficiency meaning. Now let's, today is the second video class of the business study. Now we'll start a next chapter, features of management and characteristics of management. So for the features of management, I will explain to a 6 or 7 points. Those are indicate to the features of management. So first features is here, management is a goal oriented process. So let's see the meaning. Every organization first of all set its goal. Each and every organization has to be need first maintain a goal, which goal they want to be achieved, and thereafter the management is expected to achieve this goal, and after that some management will be accepted, the management want to be achieve this goal in efficient and effective manner. So it is a meaning of the goal oriented process. I want to give an example for this point. If any student want to be set a goal that in our class 12th they have to be achieved in 95% in a class 12th board examination, but before the setting a goal they have to be make a plan, they have to be collect to all the resources, they have to give the time for the study, they have to make a proper daily routine, they have to make a proper chart, timetable, study timetable. So it's all the process under the management. So if they have to be achieve the goal, so that we can say management is goal oriented process. And then students, second is management is a pervasive. Management is pervasive. So see the meaning. Management is present everywhere, whether in a business or non-business entities. Students, these are main point. Management is a pervasive. Pervasive means is a universal. Universal, we can say a universal. Universal means we can say next one meaning is omnipresent. Those are our business organizations. Those are non-business entities. It means just like we can say a non-profit organizations in a country, in other one country, in other one overseas countries. So management is applicable, pervasive, universal in the all the sectors. But is that something we can say a changed function of the management, but the function of management is everywhere. Next features of process is continuous process. Continuous, it means regularly. So right now continuous or never ending functions. Management is a continuous or never ending function. If the management has to be start in the organizations, that to be never ending. Ye kabhi bhi ending nahi hota hai. First, the management has function we start from the planning, organizing, staffing, directing, and controlling. So management will be start from the planning. After the plan, they have to be organized. After the organizing, they have to do the appointment of the staff. After the staffing, they have to be direct to the work. And after the directing, they will control. And after the controlling, again, they will do the planning. So if the life of the organizations, when it is the life of the organizations, the management will be continuing. If a student, and your example, if you are a student, you are make a plan for the class 10th for the 90%, 95%. If you have to be achieve your goal and you have to make it again the plan for the class 10th, after the class 10th, you will make a plan for the class 11th, after the class 11th, you will make a plan for the class 12th, and after the class 12th, you will make a plan for the your graduation, post graduation, and your career. It means it is a continuous process, it is called the all the channels have to be passed, it is a management, and you will do the continue planning. Next one is here, management is a group activity. It is a important point. Management is a group activity. Group means working together in a team. So on yesterday definition, I have to be told to you that management is not a work for a single person. Management is a work for the teamwork. So when the management in a start to work, so in a single organization, a lot of departments, few departments are for a financing department, few departments for a sales department, few departments for the sales promotion departments, and production department, purchase department, sales department. So each and every department will work together for the achieving the organization goal. Those are the main motto, and we can say it is a group activity. All the departments, all the persons, all the individuals will do the work with together. Next is here, management is a dynamic. Dynamic, its meaning is there. Management is makes to change in goals, objectives, and other activities according to changes taking place in the environment. It means, student, if any changes in the organizations by the external environment to the society, so management that can be available for to change their goals and the objectives and activities. They having a quality for the changes on your organization's goals by their environment. So we can say it is a management is dynamic. Management is a quicker for taking the decisions. I want to give an example for the dynamic. Before, we have to be observed, before 10 years, each and every organization are using a desktop computer. But according to demand of the customers, according to demand of the society, this desktop has to be replaced for the LCD or LED monitors. One more example, before the 6 or 7 years, persons are used to a keypad phone. But as per the demand of the consumer, as per demand of the technology, the market has to be changed, a touch screen mobile phone. The management has to be accepted technology by the demand of the consumer. So we can say management is a dynamic. Next is here, management is a intangible force. Students, this point you have to observe in your institutional institute, in your schools, because management function can be physical seen. We can do the work for the management, but its presence can be feel. हम लोग उसके work को क्या करते हैं? Feel करते हैं. It is an intangible force of the management. We can't see the work of the management. ये अगर example आपके पास में school का example है, बहुत अच्छा example है कि जहाँ पर management क्या करता है? सारी चीजों को manage करता है for your better education. For a better institutions have to maintain an atmosphere, but these fear and these motivation not to be physically seen, you can only for the feel. So it is a intangible force. Those are having the management. Next and last feature of management is multidimensional. It means in our organizations, all the channels and all the sectors are do the work by the management. Now see the board. Management does not mean one single activity. It means management is not do the work only for a single activity, but it is include three main activities for the synchronize of to all the work by the management. So they have to be followed only for the three main activities. It is a main concept for the this topic. It is a case study question. First point is the management of work. All the work in the organizations that have to be considered by the management. The first point. First work is planning. What to do, how to do, who has to do, where and when to do. The first work, the work is done by the management. And all the decisions, all the objective decisions, just like for we can say, resolving the problem are facing by the employee on the job. It is the work for the management. Preparing budget, preparing to watch out to all the work of the employee is done by under the work of the management. It is the work of the management. Second is the management of people. It is a difficult task in the organizations. because managing people who are working in the organizations. Manage to the persons, those are coming to joining in the organizations from the different qualification, different reason and different having a sex and the categories. They have to be maintain a coordination among the peoples, those are work in the organizations. So it is a management of people, it is a work of the management to manage to all the persons for the work only for the beneficial of the organization and for achieving the goals. Management of operation. In this operation, to refers to all the activities, those are belonging to buying of raw material to semi-finished goods or finished goods. All the work is done by under the operation. When the goods are manufactured in the organizations, those process they have to be used for the manufacture of the goods, it is called a operations. And one more thing, when under the operations, joining of the work and the people. So here about management of operation is accelerated with management of work and people together. Those work they have to be done with the together, work and people will do the work with together, it is called a operations. And now after complete this topic, next topic we will explain on the next video, objectives of the management. Till this, you can note down this topic in your copy and learn this. Thank you, students.
Do self-study at home and stay home, save lives. Thank you very much.